Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. If I think back to the last few runs, I did a Cain run followed by a Judas run. So I think this Isaac run, you know, the time is ripe for it, because it's been a while. I used to play Isaac, like, every single video, because I love the D6 so much. But kind of mixed it up a little bit. People have been wondering, hey, Northernlion, why don't you play Maggie? Maggie is a slow-ass biatch, and I have no interest in taking forever just to get from room to room. We're going to reroll this magnet. Surprise! Maggie gets some revenge on us by getting the Yum Heart instead of the Magnet. I really have no interest in either of those. So instead what we're gonna do is recharge our D6 one more time. Ooh, that was pretty close. Ah, that one. He actually got me that time. It's like fighting Gertie all over again. Running into Gluttony so quickly is kind of surprising. To me, at least. Oh, get out of there! And I took some more damage. It's been a pretty quality run so far, as you can tell. Already taken 2 hits of damage on the third room that I came across. So unfortunately, we will not have our D6 for after the boss fight, but that's okay. Normally, you want to save it for the boss fight room because on later floors, if you get the opportunity to trade with the devil, that can be like exceptionally valuable. That can be make or break, basically. But on these first few runs, it doesn't really matter that much. At least in my professional opinion. And I guess I am as close to a professional Binding of Isaac player as you can get, I guess, next to, like, Edmund McMillan, who also, of course, created the game. I don't want to do the boss fight yet, unfortunately, but I do have money, so we could potentially go to the shop. Please just... Yes, thank you. The last room actually had an enemy in it, so I could recharge my D6, which is nice. We got one bomb, one key, so I'm going to be a little bit stringent on my use of those. Otherwise, we will just make our way to the boss room here. Or, sorry, the item room. Reroll this and hope for a passive, because I don't want to get rid of my spacebar item. Ah, that's pretty good. Halo of Flies. This is going to give us a little added defense. And if we can just pick up a single cube of meat, then we'll basically have an impenetrable fortress. A veritable Isaac chastity belt, if you will. But, of course, in order to make use of that, we are first going to have to actually defeat this boss. Just going to check quickly, hoping there was a key or a bomb contained therein. Sadly, no. We got a champion version of Monstro here. I don't expect that he's going to be too much of a problem. I could be a little ballsy and try to stand close to him, because I think my like Halo of Flies will just tear this dude apart. But I'm a little scared about standing so close to him, because I don't want to take damage for no reason. Although he will drop a heart, so it might be worth at least trying. Yeah, see, those do a ton of damage, but you gotta... It's like a very much risk-reward type of thing. Because obviously standing right next to a monster that can belch bullets at you is pretty risky. But this is also speeding things up, I think, anyway. It looks like it's tearing him up. That might just be my bullets, though. I don't know. I'm coming up with all sorts of novel strategies for Isaac lately. This is a surprisingly difficult boss fight. I feel like maybe this Monstro is a little bit stronger than the average version. Maybe that's what his champion-ness does. But oh well. He'll die just like the rest of them. We'll pick up a range upgrade, because we really don't have any choice in the matter, since my D6 is gone. That's fine. It was worth it to get the Halo of Flies. I could have gotten Yum Hearts and then rerolled that range up. Hey, there we go. Awesome damage upgrade from the rock on the... second floor, so now we are going to have a little bit of increased damage, which of course, as I've been saying for like 6 months now, is my most coveted attribute. Range is basically useless, speed is only useful if you're already super slow and you need something to rectify that. Damage, always useful, but I am out of bombs now. We have a mini mush that's going to give us even more speed plus range. Of course, after ragging on speed plus range, I'm going to pick that item up without re-rolling it. Well, my reasoning there is that it's a passive, and having passives is always nice. There's always a chance I could re-roll that and get a shitty active, which I wouldn't even be able to pick up because I'd want to hold onto my D6 for, you know, proper use later. And now our D6 is available for the potential of a deal with the devil or a... just a reroll on whatever the boss gives us, because sometimes the boss is going to give us shitty items. This picking up that speed and range up could have saved us the alternative of a speed or range up from the boss, if that makes any sense. At least that was the reasoning that's going on in my head as I made that decision, and I'm sticking to it. Generally speaking, I prefer to get passives as opposed to actives, at least this early. There's another tinted rock, so we'll use a bomb on that to pick up 2 spirit hearts. Very valuable. Especially, oh god, this early in the game, that was pretty close. We'll get Wrath to continue shooting at us here, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem, is my guess. And I would love to just, come on. He's got, like, 1 hit left in. I would love to pick up a cube of meat on this floor so I could get that, like, superpower defense all the way up. Ooh! Another troll bomb there. We got 2 extra bombs, could potentially find the secret room, which could be viable, because of course, that would give me enough money to go to the shop, probably, depending on what item we found in the secret room. But I may just save these two bombs, because it's possible that those will become exceptionally useful if I ever end up getting low on health. And I may indeed be low on health if I choose to go to the deal with the devil room, which right now it's looking like I have a decent chance to do, provided I don't take too much damage. Right now this has been a pretty solid run, despite those that damage I took on the first floor. So we'll fight the boss here, we'll probably use our D6. Oh man, the pony, that's pretty good. I could get rid of the D6 to grab the pony. I've been getting the pony a lot lately. Which is kind of surprising to me, because I used to consider it like a very rare boss. Like, I got it once when the DLC pack came out. In like, oh come on, yes, I avoided that. In like the first game when the DLC pack came out. And I got it very rarely since then. I can't believe I haven't taken damage yet. This has been exceptionally lucky in my opinion. Okay, the pony's actually dead, so now we can just fight the bodiless dude here. We don't have to worry so much about creep anymore. There's no way I should have gotten out of this fight without using my... or without taking damage, I should say. Okay, we're gonna pick up... neither of these are passive items, so we're gonna reroll. I'll take the Ouija board, and then I'll come back in here and take the pony, because now the combination of these two items work very well together, because now I can like hide, basically like I'm flying, and then use my Ouija board tears to take people out from an easily defensible position. But I am a little bit low on health now, so I have to be cautious. Ouija board is always a nice option, because I can basically hang out over top of a rock and I'll be unkillable. But this is an interesting run so far, that's for damn sure. Some health that we can't use. Gotta be very mindful of my my spirit hearts in this situation. Oh god, he says as he takes damage. Because, obviously, those are non-replenishable, but they're also my major source of vitality right now. So I have to be a little bit cautious. We're gonna shoot the TNT here. TNT sometimes takes a little bit longer to shoot when you're using the Ouija board, for whatever reason. Some kind of... oh, I just dodged right into that. This is not going well so far. I guess the good news is, once we lose all these spirit hearts, I can eventually just, you know, use all of that... or all of those regular hearts I've left scattered around the floor to replenish my health. We do have a bomb, and we do have a tinted rock here. That was weird. Gives us a solo key and a pill, which will hopefully be health up. Another pretty fly, that's awesome as well. And because we can fly, we can just come in here, pick up these two bombs, and then get the hell out of Dodge. Let's see what else we got coming across here. The pony, or sorry, the pony. This is... why have I forgotten this guy's name? It's not Sloth, it's not Envy, it's not Wrath. It's Pride, that's what it is. Oh. That was a little too close for comfort in my opinion. There we go. He's destroyed. Two tarot cards. Hero font would be awesome. World card is nice. Justice card is okay. Let's pop this world card to see what we're dealing with here. Alright, and then we'll hold on to the justice card, which could become incredibly useful if we get low on health or we need a bomb or a key for something. First we'll go to the secret room here, get enough money to make the shop a worthwhile option. Oh, well, we'll just blow up the slot machine. Another pill. Please be a good one. Bad gas. This is a neutral pill. Not a big fan of that, but this is one of those rooms where, you know, having the pony is going to prove exceptionally useful, because there's absolutely no way that these silkworms can get to me, which is good, because otherwise, I'm not sure if I would have the damage to take these guys out as easily. So we'll come down here to check out the item room, and I will hold on to my spacebar active pony components here. Pony component, get it? That's Book of Belial. Useful item, but not really useful for me right now, because I still need this pony. The pony is like an active passive, like it requires the spacebar item, but it's nice just to have it in a slot anyway, if what I'm saying to you makes sense, which it may not, because I kind of don't even make sense to myself right now. It's fine, we'll just continue doing some circle strafing here. Bodiless heads have basically no recourse with which to catch up to me. There's another bad gas pill, which is not nearly as good as this justice pill which I was holding. Could save our lives one day. And I do have 5 keys, so I think going to the shop is going to be viable, even though if something costs 15 cents, I won't be able to buy it. Oh, that chocolate milk looks real nice right now. Real, real nice. And so does that attack fly, actually. That would work really well with the regular flies that I got right now. Let's use Justice. It's going to give us one scent, one key, and a heart I can't use, as well as a bomb. And I really just want some money now. But I don't think we're going to get it unless... I don't know. We'll just go fight the devil. Or not fight the devil. We'll fight the boss here, see what we got. And this is actually a really good boss for us to be fighting at this point in our, you know, this Isaac's career. Because I can just stand on top of this rock and be free of the danger of the fistula. Basically just spamming bullets in here and I'll be completely inaccessible to him. And his silkworms. And I'll still be able to shoot because of the Ouija board. So both of those were good pickups. It's amazing how much the success of this run has hinged so far on the that first deal with the devil room. Because I could have gone with like the nail and that would have been something. We'll just go down to the next floor. But instead I chose to go the other way with things because Ouija board and the pony seem like a good defensive combo. I mean, it's less of an offensive combo. There we go. Use my pony active there. I really am not a huge fan of the active on the pony, but I suppose it works okay. Anyway, all I'm trying to say is that the tone of the rest of this video was entirely determined by that first deal with the devil ring. It's crazy to think what might have been. Let's shoot this poop. Really just need one more scent to not make the same mistake that I made with that shop earlier. Because now I'm thinking, man, it would have been awesome if I could get that chocolate milk, but I'm not sure that there's anything I could have done to make it happen. Maybe I could have sold an attack fly back to the shop. We'll hope for good item rooms, we'll hope for good drops from boss rooms. And right now I actually do not want to fight one of the horsemen of the apocalypse. The reason for that obviously being that the cube of meat, I'm not even sure where it would fit in on my already awesome defensive system here with the three defensive flies, or halo of flies, whatever you want to call it. Stars takes us to the secret room? Yes, item room, where we will find the bean. One of the least useful items in the game, I would say. It's not mom's pad level bad, but it is pretty awful, all things considered. But in the meantime, we'll just take out these Isla Zoos guys. Not going to be a problem with my pony in conjunction with that little bit of increased damage I have as a result of the rock. And then we'll do exactly the same room over again, but kind of a little bit trickier, at least for me, because I almost took damage there right at the start. Pony is recharged. We may just choose to fight the boss right away. I'm guessing that it's going to be Peep or Gertie. Like, you very rarely get through the caves without fighting at least one of those two. Gertie might actually be better for me to fight, because oftentimes in the Gertie level there's rocks that you can hide behind. Well, we're going to fight Pestilence, so this is going to be like a Knight's Tale. Some sweet horseman dueling here. Well, that was pretty bad use of the pony on my part. I don't know why I'm so worried about the creep, since I can just fly over it. And I could just hang out on top of a rock, but that's going to really slow down my progress. So I guess we will have to be contented to deal with our cube of meat, which is fine. I mean, cube of meat's still a solid item, and it has the potential to become something more. But it's not going to do anything for us immediately, and, you know, what have you done for me lately, cube of meat? What have you done for me lately? It's an attitude that our generation deals with these days. Again, not sure why I'm so freaking worried about the creep. Basically worthless. There we go. Silkworms are dead. Now all he can spawn are flies. And bombs, of course. Shouldn't be so bad. He will go down. And we have another opportunity to trade with the devil. I actually hope this is Krampus. Yes, okay, good. Now we're just going to be exceptionally cautious. Try not to die. The reason I hoped it was Krampus was because I didn't have enough money or enough hearts to do a trade with the devil anyway. So stupid. Jesus Christ. So I might as well, take the opportunity to get this item, which I do not need to trade any hearts for. That was close. It's actually bad that I have the pony here because I'm moving so fast that it's making it difficult for me to dodge. But I'm kind of just trying to goad him into doing the laser attack, because when he does that, I know I can get out of there quickly. And as long as I don't die here, I mean, there's like hearts remaining on this level that I can just go pick up. So I'm just being exceptionally cautious right now. Lump of Coal is going to be a really nice item in conjunction with the Ouija board and the pony, because again, that gives us a little bit more added offense. which is awesome. I mean, my defense is perfectly fine now. Basically, just as a result of the pony alone. Whew, it's been kind of a stressful boss fight here. Ah, that was stupid. I dodged too far. Dodge Too Far, my favorite Alec Guinness movie. Okay, so just being a little bit more cautious here. I think, you know, smart money's on my survival in this fight. Things were looking a little harrowing at the start when I took so much damage right away for no reason. In the meantime, just gonna continue spamming bullets at him. Ooh, it's a load off right there. I was feeling myself becoming, like, physically stressed. There we go, Lump of Coal, extra bomb. Alright, so now Lump of Coal, if you're not familiar, which you may not be, because, you know, I know some people are just getting into this game now with the announcement of Wrath of the Lamb. The further our bullets travel, oh, that's good too. That nickel is very nice. The further our bullets travel, the more damage that they do. So, considering that I got that range up at the start, maybe that wasn't such a bad idea. Now I have incredible range, incredible defense. I can basically shoot across the entire level and my shots will do a ton of damage. So we're going to try to get ourselves to the shop. I will steal whatever is in here. Skeleton key, that is really useful right now. And we'll just get the hell out of there because we can fly. I'll spend this money at the shop, hopefully on some kind of passive item that will give me maybe increased damage or increased health. Or I guess I could just blow it on a ton of spirit hearts. That wouldn't necessarily be a bad investment, but if there's something like the relic, I would rather get that, of course. The pony is basically an endgame item. We can use that until we get to the womb. Alright, free money. I'll wait for this bomb to explode, of course. Making my life easier. And thank God I didn't pick up the magnet, because that would have been useless in conjunction with the pony. Or redundant, at least. Maybe not useless, but useless given the combination of items that I would have had. So we'll just keep it up here. Still need some way to regenerate health. Like, keep in mind, I still have less health than I started with. But tons of bombs, tons of keys. Alright, Lust has no chance. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do to me? You're slower, you can't go through rocks. You're totally useful. Or as I would say, redundant. We'll die, and we will get a pill, which hopefully is not bad. Tears up, that's useful. And we only have one more direction to go to basically figure out where the hell the shop is, finally. And then we can move on, so. You know what would be really useful here? Homing tears, because I'm still having, occasionally, situations where I have to put myself in harm's way. But with homing tears, I could just spam shots from across the level. They would do more damage the further they traveled, and I can just hang out in the corner on every single level and literally have zero risk. That would be excellent. I was kind of thinking we'd run into greed here, but instead, nope. I'll shoot this fire eventually. Pick up the bomb bag, because it's a nice passive. 5 cents for a spirit heart doesn't feel so bad. Probably not going to blow that 5 cents on the key, considering I already have 98 of them. I mean, it'd be nice to have 99, have Gretzky keys. Instead, I will be contented to only have Jaromir Jagr keys. And we'll just move on to the next floor. Not too worried about the secret room. I've got 15 cents. Not going to spend my money on Judgment because I can possibly buy something from the shop on the next floor. Just to explain my thought process a little bit. Now, this is the kind of room that I don't like getting into when you have the pony because there's no advantage to having it here except for the fact that you move faster. But we made our way through it anyway. This is the room I more enjoy because it has like rocks and shit that I can use to avoid certain death. I'm going to use as many bombs as I need to hurt these guys. That didn't help at all. Oh, it opened up the level a little bit, which, you know, runs entirely contrary to what I was saying before about this level being good because it was closed. Oh well. The pony, the zombies, like, the pony is a mild counter to zombies because we can obviously, like, not worry so much about the geography of the level. Good pill? Oh no. Well, we'll just escape here and hope that we don't have to backtrack, because if we do, I will almost certainly forget that there are bombs in that room and lose that spirit heart if I still have it. For now, we are coming up on the item room, which is awesome. Extra bomb via the bomb bag. Luckfoot. Might as well get it. I mean, there's no reason not to. There's a blood bank, which I have no interest in, but I do have an interest in this gauntlet room, because I can fly in and just take the money and run, smash and grab style. Try to get this penny without activating the blood bank. Ooh, sure, why not? I've got 97 keys, so even though we didn't get anything from that, we didn't really lose anything from it either. Let's explode this blood bank. Another heart that I can't use. I really should have played the blood bank because there's a heart in this room. Oh, right, I forgot about this. Luckily, they all exploded simultaneously. Yeah, definitely should have played the blood bank a few times. Oh, well. Not always the brightest bulb in the shelf, am I? Get it? Because I deliberately messed up brightest bulb on the tree, or I don't know. Brightest bulb in the socket. I don't know. I've forgotten the way that this expression works. And my shots look exactly like these little envy blocks, which is making dodging very stressful for me. So you gotta look for the faces. Don't shoot until you see the blacks of their eyes. I got a couple more to deal with here, but this has largely been not a problem. Would really love to come across some more tinted rocks that I could blow up and get spirit hearts. Firing my laser is a decent item, but I still prefer having this pony. So, we'll move ourselves over to the right here. Destroy this human popcorn. And there's a couple directions we can go after this. If I was the boss room and the shop, where would I be hiding? I feel like the shop is going to be bottom right corner, so that's where I'm going to go first. And the item room, or sorry, the boss room is going to be upper right corner. But we'll see. Definitely making me regret not going to the blood bank by dropping all these hearts on every single fucking level. Take out these zombies without alerting it is like playing Left 4 Dead. We're trying to kill these zombies without letting the other zombies see us and thus alerting the horde. Oh, that was close. Hate how these guys can turn on a dime. But again, Pony's a nice little counter to these zombie rooms. It's the closest thing to, you know, Brimstone without actually having Brimstone. Let's just fly over here, take out these nubs. Again, Pony's a nice counter. Oh, I took damage! It's been a while since I took damage like that, so it's stressing me out, man. Just get off my back. Take these guys out. Abusing that sick range advantage I got in the early game. Well, there's the boss room, so it turns out I was full of shit. Boss room is going to be down here. I'll continue exploring until I find the item room then. Doing really well on bombs, gotta say. So I would love to get the item room. Ideal item room, relic. This is like the one time I will say that a battery is not that appealing. So we're just gonna do some little diagonal dodges here. Anytime they jump, if you put yourself in a diagonal position, they won't be able to hit you. But unfortunately, that strategy doesn't always hold up, because sometimes like four of them jump at once. So, continue. My heart rate. I feel like dehydrated and sweaty and probably smell bad. It's been a stressful run for me. There's an extra key, that's good. We're back up to Jaromir Jagr. Hey! Redemption! Here's an opportunity for us to use the blood bank to possibly pick up some permanent extra health, which would be awesome, because I totally missed that opportunity the first time. At the very least, we'll pick up a little bit of extra money. Let's come up here. How many hearts do we have here? One full heart, so that's at least two more plays. Well, getting rich. And come up here. How many hearts do we have here? Another full heart. That's another two plays. Probably run into greed on this floor is my guess. And then on the depths part two, we'll have a real... We know we can play it at least one more time because there's tons of hearts scattered about. Wow! This thing's paying... It's actually better that it's not paying out with the blood bag early because now we can exploit it a little bit more. So we'll see how much health we have. I know we have two half hearts in the gauntlet room. But we might as well get back to full health and then just quickly see how much we've got over here. One full heart, two half hearts in that other room, one half heart. So I'm going to play three more times and then come back. And, you know, if I have to be a little bit careful in my work here, then I have to be a little bit careful in my work. Do due diligence in order to, you know, increase my odds as much as possible. Plus, this extra money doesn't hurt. Although I am getting a little bit bored. Wow, we are up to 40 cents now. So what I will do is come back here, get these two... hearts, well, this full one and then the half one in here, then go back to the blood bank, play it two more times, and if for whatever reason I don't get the blood bag, which would be crazy considering I've now put like eight different hearts into it, then I will come back here to the gauntlet room, get those two half hearts, and then be on my merry way with you know, a fatter purse anyway. Wow, I really can't believe that this did not pay out. That's insanity in my opinion. Whatever. We went from like 20 cents to 42 cents. This is not... Oh, there's another heart in there! I apologize for my digression here. But we will come down, play it another 2 times. And if this doesn't pay out, I swear to God, this machine is like totally, it's fixed. I can't believe that. I honestly cannot believe that. But I guess on the bright side, we are up to 44 cents now. And I guess I'm not going to blow up the blood bank yet, because there's always a chance that there will be more hearts scattered in the remaining levels that I may want to use. So we'll just go pick up this. Because I'm at full health. That was weird that all the enemies were gone, but oh well. Okay, we're back to full health, and we have a significantly heavier pockets. So we will just continue moving on here. This has been a long Depths Part 1, but it's not over yet. This shop could make or break us. There's more money. We're up to 47 cents. Money equals power would be insane right now. That would give us, like, well, just... Let's continue with the use of the I word here. That would give us insane damage. In conjunction with this, like, range up and the rock and, lump of coal, of course. Ooh, oh my god, it's another two plays of the blood bank there. Fine, let's do it. I'm a slave for you, blood bank. We're up to 50 cents. This is just comical now. 52 cents, that's a penny for every week of the year. Which is more than I got paid at my last job. So let's pick this up. Head downwards and, you know, hopefully come across some more hearts here. Because I really, as much as the money's been good, I really need this blood bag more than anything else to give me that extra health. Because right now, like, I don't feel that confident with only 2 regular hearts and 1 spirit heart. Oh, there's a bomb for us. Oh, we have the ladder, which is literally 100% useless to us with the pony. The only exception being if we got rid of the pony, then we would have a way to like, cross gaps. But we'll spend 5 cents on a spirit heart. Lord knows we can afford it. And with 17 bombs, we might as well take a look out for our secret room. There's a number of possible locations for it here. There's one up here. No such luck. One down here. No such luck. I'm not talking to you yet, Blood Bank. We'll deal with you later. Not there either. Well, okay. We'll just go fight the boss then. Reason I didn't blow up the blood bank, if I don't take any damage against the boss, it's possible that we'll end up getting some health there. Well, we're gonna get our 2nd cube of meat as well, which is nice, I guess. It's gonna make this 1st cube of meat actually useful for us. Let's use our pony here. Yeah, just do a little damage to him. Ooh, this could hurt. Not managed to get lucky. And like I said, with the pony, I will just continue putting myself in a position where I am basically unkillable. Ooh, that could have hurt. Cube of Meat and Halo of Flies really showed their usefulness there. And I'm pretty sure at this point that I'm going to beat this one without taking any damage. I can just hang out by this rock. Sorry, War, this is really bad for you. Oh well. Alright, Cube of Meat. Here we go, what do you want, Satan? Brimstone for 2 hearts? I'm pretty sure that'll kill me, so I'm not gonna pick it up. And, for the last time, I will come back here. If only that blood bank had paid out, I could have gotten Brimstone right there, and we'd be sitting pretty. We'll play this 2 more times. It's fucking comical, man. Oh my god. It finally pays out. Now I'll go back to the boss room and there won't even be a deal with the devil there, of course. Yep. Just my luck. Oh well. Continue moving onwards here. We still have definitely a good chance for success simply because of this insane defense that I have with the Ouija board. I can't... Did that... These leapers are actually jumping on top of me. Hands up if you knew that the leapers could jump on top of rocks. Because I didn't. I thought they always avoided them. Well, that cost us 1 whole spirit heart, which is pretty shitty. But I guess in the long run, that's only 5 cents. And we get another blood bank, which is great. Because Lord knows, they've been good to me lately. I guess can't complain, because it did eventually pay out. But it took its sweet time doing it, didn't it? So we'll just take out Larry Jr. Very nice room to run across right now. Very relaxing room. We'll destroy him. Pick up extra bombs, which we already have a surplus of. This is Roid Rage? Growth Hormones. This extra speed plus damage is awesome. Can't complain about that at all. And we'll just dip set from that room. No interest in that slot machine, at least not yet. Got a little bit of chub to deal with here. I guess I'll just stand like in these rocks and then chub can't hurt me. Which is awesome. If only he would stop moving around so I could hurt him more reliably. But that extra like passive damage up is awesome. I'm not going to complain about that at all. Even though it would be better for me to have Brimstone right now, Oh my god, I can't believe I still took damage, despite my incredible defense. You can't always get what you want, right? So, not having Brimstone may suck briefly, but we still have good chances on this run. We absolutely have to visit the shop, even though I'm about 65... Oh no, you know what? We won't have greed in the shop on this floor because we've already had a mini-boss by way of Sloth. That's fantastic for us. He'll drop Bob's Rotten Head, which I have no interest in at all. I'll check briefly for the secret room while I'm on my way to explore the rest of the level. So we'll come up and go around. Probably going to make good use of that blood bank in the future. And by way of this increased damage, I can pretty easily take out these feti, the fetuses. I don't understand why they aren't affected by the spikes. Personally, I think that's unfair segregation or discrimination simply based on age. I mean, fetuses get so many rights in today's economy, in today's world, that I just don't think it's fair that, you know, 8-year-olds like Isaac here aren't exposed to the same kind of freedoms and liberties as, you know, the fetus population. Which, they don't even pay taxes, man! Why do fetuses get so many rights? Sorry, I didn't mean for this to get all political. It's just I'm very passionate about, you know, the mistreatment of 8-year-olds. I have two passions in life, YouTube videos and mistreatment of 8-year-olds. That sounds wrong. Okay. We have some serious questions to deal with here. I could get rid of the pony to pick up the Book of Revelations, but then I would lose, like, my number one advantage. So I'm not gonna do that. But I will pick up Mr. Mega for increased blast damage, because I have 23 bombs. I guess I'll pick up Pretty Fly, which is worthless. And then we'll leave, so, okay. We'll go check on the shop, or sorry, the item room. But first, we might as well play the blood bank twice, because we did uncover a heart up there. And while I'm on my way, might as well get this done. There's an extra 3 cents for us, which we'll probably never be able to spend on anything ever. But in the, you know, the odd situation or the unlikely situation that I run across like 5 judgments, that'll be worth its weight in gold. So let's move over to the right here. Plenty of bomb flies. Plenty of brains. I really was tempted to pick up that Book of Revelations, I'm not gonna lie. But I'm gonna withstand my temptation. Justice card is, you know, probably useless considering how many bombs and keys I have right now. And sucks for you, Ilesus guys. This is gonna be a bad day. When will you evolve the ability to learn how to fly? Checkmate, evolutionists. If I had the pony for enough generations, wouldn't the Ilesus guys be able to fly by now? Wouldn't evolution teach them how to do that? I'm sad that I have to do this, but I have to point out that everything I've said so far is satire, because otherwise there will be at least a couple people that think, like, hey, Northernlion, you don't believe in evolution? I don't care. I mean, I have a university education in biology. Yes, I believe in evolution, but my beliefs are not important to this Let's Play. That was Dead Sea Scrolls back in the item shop over there. And I don't have any interest in that, so let's just go fight Mom, right? I guess we'll check one more time for the secret room. Like, a 1-up would actually be super useful right here. Oh well. We'll just do without, blow up this blood bank for an extra 3 cents, and that glitch, so shameful. And we'll go back here to the left, where I could play the slot machine, but what am I gonna get? More bombs, more keys? I already have 22 bombs and 97 keys. This fight, regular version of Mom here. I don't expect that this fight is going to be too difficult for us, which is a nice change of pace. I've had some harrowing runs in this Mom fight recently that I'm not really used to. So far, everything's going pretty good, I would say. Just watching out for the shadow. Mom's about, I'd say, 40% dead right now. Just try to stay away from the sides. We're continuing to do some pro MLG 360 no-scope crowd control on these minions that she's sending out. And this has been easy mode so far. And I'm very pleased with that. Oh, where did I take damage from? Must have been a fly that snuck through my, like, missile defense system. Well, that was easy enough. There's another HP upgrade for us. Another half heart that we can pick up. And then head down to the womb part one, where I have no compass and no map. And, you know, limited chances for... I'm at 50-50%. Or 50-50%? What am I talking about? 50% chance. You know, 50-50 odds of succeeding here. Don't want to get too cocky, but I do have a solid, if unorthodox, collection of items and drops right now. This isn't my traditional style of Isaac run. I prefer to go more high damage, more high health as well, but oh well. I think we got a good shot. Four hearts is not a lot, but it's something, I suppose. I'm just gonna drop a bomb in here. I think there might be some spirit hearts. Yep, hunch proven wrong. If anything, it's gonna open up the geography of this level a little bit so I can hit these sis a little easier. Maybe, I guess, unless they keep moving around. There we go. Tarot card is strength. Yeah, we'll save that. We'll use that. It's more important than justice right now because we're at full health, but that justice card could be important later. So we gotta kind of weigh the pros and the cons there, I suppose. So come across here. This might be a decent room to use strength on. Ah, it took damage already. Don't know why I got so freaked out. Should have just gone directly over the rocks. They couldn't have touched me. Instead, I went directly into an enemy, thinking, I don't know, maybe my cube of meat or my flies would take care of it for me. But anyway, thank God we used that strength card, so now that damage is actually erased. Not sure if these vaginal silkworms can fly over these rocks. Come on, that thing took so long to die. My guess is that they can, so I can't be too confident in my placement right now. That's okay, again, tons of bombs. Continue moving on here. Might be able to take these... I was hoping I could take those cysts out without having to, deal with their bullshit evasion here. Oh well, it worked out fairly well. We want to go to the right now, I suppose, and on the way back, I will pick up that justice card and probably use it to get that extra half heart right away. Nothing wrong with that. Just move over to the right now, and basically just looking for the boss room. The faster I can find that, the better. Trying to avoid. I always hurt myself on those flies. Emperor's a good card. Gonna take us directly to the boss. I'm gonna save that for the next floor, and that was a very good decision on my part because the first floor boss is right here. And it might be Skolex, who is literally zero problem. So I'm just gonna plant some bombs in the hopes that they'll do damage. So far, so awful. Haven't worked at all. And now I've set up like a barricade. There we go. That one's... Seriously? None of these are doing anything? I gotta work on my bomb placement, man. Work on my bomb placement. Seriously, I placed like 6 bombs, none of them have hit. So I'm just gonna stop wasting them, even though I still have 24 left. And we'll do things the old-fashioned way here. Wow, I am low on health and suddenly a little bit scared. I didn't realize that I had lost so much health over the past couple of rooms. Or maybe even just this room. Busy focusing on my commentary. Classic mistake. Well, there's a spirit heart and a regular heart drop. For once, the game's troll engine falls in my favor. And there we go. Skolex again. This should be super easy. If I take damage, then I'm doing something wrong. Already 50% dead, which makes this a slow boss fight so far. Just keep things up. Maybe like 3 more hits. Is my educated guess, my professional opinion, as I said earlier. If I could actually hit it, you know, that would be better, probably. That'd probably speed up the boss fight a little bit. There we go. One more hit'll do it. Of course, Skolex can't let that happen. There we go. Extra health? Awesome. And an extra health up, which is fantastic. Now we will skip the entirety of the Wound Part 2 by using the Emperor card. Get down here, and then just start taking out these lasers. The faster these go down, the faster this boss fight's gonna die. There we go, and there's full health for us, which is great. Start dropping these mega bombs that I paid 7 cents for, or 15 cents, I can't even remember. I think it was 15 cents, actually. So I gotta make sure I get my money's worth. Like I said, very unconventional run here, going for like bomb strength and mobility. Just an unusual strategy for me, but it's working really well against Mom's Heart right now. Already like 70% dead, firing bombs continuously, and I don't have to avoid the creep here, which is awesome. One of the main reasons I loved the flying ability, which you can get from various items, is that you don't have to worry about creep, particularly in this Mom's Heart boss fight, although it does come in handy against like brain guys and other mini-bosses like Sloth. Well, that was easy enough. We will now head down to the Wound Part 3 with decent chances, I would say. We got 6 hearts. One of them is a spirit heart, but by this point, it's effectively just another heart. It's all gonna depend... Such a stupid way to take damage. Now we have 5 hearts. It's all gonna depend on how well we do on the rooms leading up to Satan. Because, you know, Satan himself, fairly easy, at least in my opinion, by this point in my Isaac career. Can't believe I didn't take damage there. I'm just gonna bail out, even though there was a penny. And same thing here, I'm gonna bail out of this room as well. Because we found a dead end, and start moving my way to the right instead. Triple laser room. That's pretty awful. Yep, taking a ton of damage here. Managed to get out of it, only losing 2 hearts, which is, I would almost classify that as an unqualified success. Made sure to blow up our doppelganger. First pony! Oh, I thought it worked, yes! I knew I was going to take damage, so I just popped pony as quickly as possible to make myself invincible for a charge. Which may have saved me 1 heart of damage there. That was quick thinking, if I do say so myself. Don't normally compliment myself on stuff like that, but that's because it doesn't normally happen. I don't normally exercise ingenuity. Tons of money and an extra spirit heart drop, which is fantastic. We'll now check out the mob trap room. Get a little bit of extra health and money. We're gonna have to wait for Larry Jr. to just get the hell out of the way of the door. And there's our final boss. If we can get out of this room without taking too much damage, I think we got a chance. Just want to take out these bomb flies first. One more. And we'll just place a bomb. Blow our doppelganger up. And we've got 4.5 hearts to make this happen, so we can take 4 hits. Wait a second. Drop the bomb. Good timing. Fallen is already half dead. Let's kick another bomb over there. I think it did get one of them. Just gonna do a little Krampus-style dodging. Drop another bomb over here, which is gonna hit no one, because apparently I'm the worst bomb. Oh god, they got me trapped! Did you see that? That was nonsense. The gang violated me. Didn't want to use the R word in case someone got offended. Let's drop this bomb in here. Again, that's not gonna help us out. It's been a bad fight against the Fallen so far, but whatever, it worked out, I guess. There's our live bomb now, and our second form of Satan that is already, like, maybe 40% dead at this point. He's doing some aggressive play, which normally you don't see. Still got 2.5 hearts left. That was close. He should die in another barrage. Alright, now here comes, time to put your money where your mouth is. Dodging backwards. Trying to avoid bomb flies. My principal concern. Oh, there's one. Okay, so I can't take very much more damage. If I get this one, it's gonna be by the skin of my teeth. I'd like to point out, it's all because of that troll blood bank that we had earlier. If it had just paid out that blood bag as soon as possible, I could have gotten Brimstone and we wouldn't be in this position, but I guess this is more fun. At least for you guys. For me, it's remarkably stressful. As stressful as playing video games while talking over Top D. I can't take any more hits. Oh my god! I destroyed it, and it destroyed me at the same time, and somehow I got a loss for that. I consider that a victory. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. That is some bullshit that I do not tolerate right there. See you next time.